For this video, we're going to work on some more practice calculations and interpretation for Gibbs free energy. To begin with, I wanted to let you know that I have moved a slide around. So I'm actually starting with slide number 37 here. And a quick review of Gibbs free energy, denoted by delta G, measured in kilojoules per mole. And recognize that we have two different quantities of Gibbs free energy. We have the non-standard quantity. This quantity specifically determines spontaneity. And when we say that a reaction is spontaneous, we mean that it is still moving forward to reach equilibrium. We'll start to compare this quantity to delta G naught. This superscripted zero symbol is called the not symbol, which denotes standard Gibbs free energy. And this quantity, delta G naught, determines whether a reaction is product favored or reactant favored at equilibrium. In the next video or two, we'll get into more detail of those, but just wanted to define those. As you are asked to calculate Gibbs free energy, it's important for you to recognize whether you are calculating standard or non-standard delta G. Actually, I'm going to go back a slide. To calculate standard delta G, every quantity must be in standard notation or standard measurements. That means that if we are calculating Gibbs free energy using enthalpy, the enthalpy value must be standard, the entropy value must be standard, and our temperature must be at 298 Kelvin, or if we're converting from Celsius, you have the option of using the 0.15. So all three of those quantities must be met in order for it to be standard free energy. If we're calculating non-standard free energy, if any one of those is non-standard, then we are calculating non-standard delta G. So if temperature is not standard, we're calculating non-standard. If enthalpy or entropy is non-standard, then we're calculating the non-standard delta G. As a practice question, I have students look at each one of these examples listed here, numbers 1, 2, and 3, and determine whether you're calculating standard or non-standard delta G. And then as a practice, to actually calculate the value of delta G or delta G naught for each one. So looking at question number 1, notice we have standard enthalpy. We have standard entropy, but notice temperature. Since this is at 115 Kelvin, this is non-standard delta G that we are calculating. Again, only one quantity needs to be non-standard for it to be non-standard delta G. For our second example, we have standard enthalpy, standard entropy, and our temperature is standard. This means that we are calculating delta G naught, the standard value for Gibbs free energy. For our third example, notice we have non-standard enthalpy, non-standard entropy, but we do have standard temperature. Because our first two quantities are non-standard, we are calculating non-standard delta G. And so again, for this slide, I recommend that you practice calculating the respective values of delta G, making sure you understand how to plug the values in and report for sig figs. Moving on, we will work with a practice calculation. For our equation, we're working with the formation of rust, and here I've given the balanced chemical equation. I first want you to start by predicting the signs of enthalpy, entropy, and delta G. Remember, for enthalpy, we're looking at types of reactions. Sorry about that little glitch there. For enthalpy, we look at types of reactions, whether we're making or breaking bonds. Recognize in this reaction, we have a combination reaction. Most combination reactions, we predict to be a negative value. We are forming more bonds, which is an exothermic process. For entropy, we are looking at disorder. We're looking at whether we're creating more order or more disorder as the reaction happens. Again, because it's a combination reaction, we tend to predict that this is also going to be a negative value. And if you remember from our prediction of delta G, because both of our quantities are predicted to be negative, this is going to be temperature dependent. Because it's exothermic, if we look at our free energy equation, delta G equals delta H minus T delta S. Because exothermic is favored, we want that quantity to outweigh or to be larger than the product of our temperature times enthalpy. And so the only way that can happen is if our temperature is low. And remember, as we discussed, the value of what is a low temperature is reaction dependent. So we would predict it to be negative as long as we would predict the delta G to be negative as long as our temperature is low enough. For our question, we're asked, is the reaction spontaneous at 515 degrees Celsius? We are given our enthalpy and entropy values here. But again, recognize because our temperature is non-standard, we are calculating our non-standard value of delta G. I apologize for the glitches, still getting used to the system. So again, for our setup, we have our value of enthalpy minus our temperature, converting our Celsius into Kelvin. So adding 273.15, there's our temperature conversion, multiplying that by our entropy value converted into kilojoules. So that is a negative. Sorry, bad formatting, running out of space here. Kilojoules per Kelvin. So plugging all of that in, we have our temperature conversion first. This comes out to be a 788.15. And this 0.15 is optional. I will ask when you show your work that you show me which conversion you're using. I will grade your work based on whichever temperature you use. So again, that 0.15 is optional. Times our entropy value, remembering to convert that into kilojoules. When we subtract that product from our enthalpy, we get a value of negative 1214.9. So again, my suggestion, my rule that I follow for sig figs to simplify things is to look at how many decimal places my original values of enthalpy and entropy had. They both had one decimal place, so I'm going to go to one decimal place here. And then, of course, our units here will just be kilojoules because our kelvins, forgot to write that in here, our kelvins canceled out. So we have a value of delta G for negative 1214.9 kilojoules. And again, remember, we're asked, is this reaction spontaneous? Because our delta G is less than zero, this tells us we do have a spontaneous reaction, meaning at this temperature, it will go. The follow-up question here, so here's our solution we just worked through. The follow-up question is, at what temperature does this reaction change spontaneity, and is it spontaneous above or below this temperature? Remember, our calculation here to solve for temperature is to set up our enthalpy divided by entropy. Because we're dividing here, when we report a final answer, we will report that in sig figs. And also realize that the units here are kilojoules will cancel out. In this calculation, we're left with just units of Kelvin. Because our entropy goes to 4 sig figs, we are limited to 4 sig figs in our answer, and again, that is Kelvin. So this is the temperature at which it changes spontaneity. Now we want to know if it's spontaneous above or below that. So again, two ways to answer that. One is we calculated previously that it was spontaneous at 788. So we already know that it is spontaneous below that temperature. Another way to think about it is to look at the signs of enthalpy and entropy. Since both of these are negative, again, when we predict delta G, we know that a reaction will be spontaneous at relatively low temperatures. For this reaction, low means anything below our calculated value of 2,997 Kelvin. By the way, ignore these slide numbers. I have tweaked mine a little bit to help with this. So 2,997 Kelvin, hopefully that number kind of jumps out at you. That's a really large number. It would actually be impossible to carry this reaction out above that temperature, practically speaking, right? 3,000 Kelvin. In the notes, I have a little side note for you that the surface of the sun is about 5,700 Kelvin. So we're almost halfway there with this temperature. Essentially, solid iron wouldn't exist anymore, neither would oxygen. So practically speaking, this reaction couldn't run above that temperature. So it has to be below.